I see a lot of you have out your multiplication tables and set out there when you do your homework. Please don't do that. You are just nothing but enabling yourself to take longer at math than it really should take. You must know your multiplication tables. You will do nothing but hurt yourself if you continue on that way. You know, if you don't know them, have your parents quiz you over them. Learn them. You're in fifth grade now. It should come second nature to all of them. Especially when we talk about triple digit multiplication, because it just gets nothing but more difficult. Write down this problem. Oh, look, here's a good one. 2, 3, 4 times 1, 2, 3. I love this. Okay, now, just like with double digit multiplication, before we actually go do the algorithm for this, which makes it much simpler or just more organized, I guess, you have to remember when we multiply these, what we're doing. Remember that whole distributive property thing with double digit multiplication? The same thing is true with this. Instead of doing this problem like this, if I really wanted to, I could take 234 and multiply it by not a 1 here, but a, what is that? Because it's in that place, it's a 100. Okay, then I would have to take this 234 and multiply it by a, what would be the next thing? The 2, but it's not a 2, it's a 20. And then I'd have to take a 234 and multiply it by a 3. That one is a 3. And then add all those together, and I'm going to get my answer here. Well, let's do it just to make sure we're doing it right here. Okay. What is 234 times 100? Just got done talking about that. I get, drop down the zeros, 234. I get 23,400. Yeehaw for the big numbers. What is 234 times 20? Bring down my 0, 8, 6, 4. I get 4,680. And what is 234 times 3? 3 times 4 is 12, 9, 10, 0, 6, 7. I get 702. Now, if all goes correctly, through the miracle of this board, I'm going to do this just because I can. I'm going to scooch this over here. If this all works correctly, when I do this multiplication out using the algorithm, this is what I should get. I should end up adding 702 for this row plus 4,680 for the second row plus 23,400 for the last row. Adding all those answers up together, I end up with hopefully 28,782. Okay. This is doing it out that whole distributive kind of group by group by group way. Usually when we do the problem, we do it in one big clump over here. I don't know if you've ever done triple digit multiplication, but it's just like double digit with another digit. Okay. Remember, the algorithm for this is we always start in the ones place and we multiply the 3 by all 3 of those, which you end up with, what, 12. 3 times 3 is 9 plus 1 is 10. 3 times 2 is 6 plus 1 is 7. There's my 702 that was right there. Now, when you get to the 2, what do you have to do? From here on in, Jenny, you got to... Right, because this is in the 20s place, or in the 10s place, it means 20, and I start with the 0. And then I multiply, let's change colors. Then I multiply by the 2. 2 times 4 is 8, 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 2 is 4. And look, there's my 4680 that I got when I multiplied by 20. And then, probably new, when you get to the hundreds digit over here, what do I have to remember to do, Kara?
Add 2 zeros.
Put 2 zeros. When you get to the second one, you add 1 zero. When you get to the third one, you add 2. Guess what? If I was doing 4-digit, I'd have to add 3, and so on and so on. And then 1 times 4 is 4. 1 times 3 is 3. 1 times 2 is 2. And look, I get the same thing I got here. And then adding them, hopefully I end up with the same thing when I add. What did I get? 2 and 6. what did I get, 7? No, it should be 7, sorry. 7. So doing it like this is really the exact same thing as doing it like this, except we do a whole bunch of different little shortcuts. Now, the thing you have to be careful with is this. You know, as you're doing all this stuff, you end up starting to get a lot of numbers, little numbers up here, and you got to keep straight which one you're on. So some people, I don't know, do some people erase their numbers after that? Okay. If it helps you, scribble them out, get rid of them, because, and again, that a lot of times you get more confused if you have to think about what 3 times 4 is than if you know 3 times 4 is 12 right off the bat. Because really, I mean, if you have to think about 3 times 3, and or some of you use your little finger calculators or whatever you use, you know, you're going to get more messed up than if you know it right off the bat. Because in reality, you know, if you have something like 721 times 3, 4, 5, you know, if you know your multiplication tables, this problem should take you no more than maybe 30 seconds or so. You know, 5 times 1, 5 times 2 is 10. 36, bring down to 0, 4, 8, 28, put a couple zeros, 3, 6, and 21, and just add them together, 5, 4, what is that, 17, 12, 18, 4, 2, I mean, it should not take you a long time to multiply that out, if you know your multiplication tables. But if you have to think what 3 times 7 is, or what 3 times 2 is, or all that stuff, it's going to take you quite a while. I'm going to have you do one. If you all pretty much seem like you get it, then I'll give you lots of time to get your homework done, because I know you don't want homework over the weekend.
No,
you never
had
this over the weekend. Especially
not for my birthday.
Whose birthday?
My birthday's on Wednesday.
You guys have
Wednesday.
And Maggie's. We have 3 birthdays on the same day.
Go ahead and do this problem, please. And the other thing, please let me, you know, suggest that, you know, make sure you keep your stuff in nice straight rows and columns when you do them out. If you're sloppy, you just end up with a lot of imperfection. You should be just about done.
Yeah. You know what you can do?
Turn it
get
off.
Like a board, and then when they come out of the line,
El Completo.
No
mass.
Probably the best, some of you said cross that off, that's probably not a bad idea. Don't forget to put your 0 down and start that next column. 3 times 7 is 21. 3 times 8, 24 plus 2 is 26. 12 12 plus 2 is 14. Right?
Yes.
Yes.
Scribble these off again.
Scribbles.
Two zeros in the hundreds place. 6 times 7 is 42. 6 times 8 is 48 plus 4 is 52. Those get kind of hard. 6 times 4 is 24 plus 5 is 29.
Yes.
800 is 8. 4 plus 1 is 5. 9 plus 6 is 15. 16 is 17. 1, 2, 6, 7, 8. 9 plus 1 is 10.
Yeah!
Did I get it right?
Yes.